Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished panelists, and dear participants of the 7th UNISEC Global Meeting, I apologize for not being able to be with you today to commemorate the 7th meeting of the UNISEC Global in Tokyo due to the meetings I have to attend in Germany. Despite my absence, I wanted, however, to share a short message on the topic of this upcoming panel, which is very close to my heart, namely gender equality in the space sector. As the first woman to lead a large-scale German research institution, the German Aerospace Center, TLR, gender equality in STEM holds not just a professional, but also a personal significance for me. I believe this topic to be one of the most important dimensions of science and technology developments in the 21st century. We saw a lot of progress in the recent years, for example, through the efforts of the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals, which acknowledge gender equality as a dedicated objective. The access of women, in particular in science and technology, must be encouraged and supported. Thankfully, there are constantly new milestones that we can look forward. Just a few weeks ago, on the 18th of October, the astronauts Christine Koch and her colleague Jessica Meyer performed the first all-female spacewalk in history. This was a momentous occasion for women all around the world, not only for the space sector. Even so, let us not forget that this AVA occurred 56 years after Valentina Tereshkova's did the first female spaceflight, which points to an underlying difficulties that women still face in the space sector. I look forward to the next milestone, namely celebrating the first woman on the moon as part of the NASA Artemis program in the next decade. And I think it would also be nice that we do not think that an all-female spacewalk is a special occasion, but that is actually completely normal. Governments around the world must continue this effort of inclusion through new initiatives such as Die Astronautin, a project in Germany which aims to send privately the first German female astronaut to the International Space Station in the upcoming years. Of course, I also believe it is up to each of us to facilitate gender equality in space and other STEM subjects. In my position as the chair of the executive board of the German Aerospace Center, I support several initiatives that educate girls and young women in the STEM field. For example, through our DLR School Labs and the DLR Girls Day program. This is of particular importance since by using space fascination and excitement, we can motivate the younger generations to engage into the STEM activities before they actually join the university. I'm also pleased to report that on the 25th October, I was inaugurated as the first female president of the International Astronautical Federation, the IAF. Where we'll continue to work with many female and also male vice presidents to increase efforts for inclusiveness and diversity. Many IAF activities target the principles of 3G, namely geography, generation, and gender. Furthermore, as Chancellor of the International Space University, I'm also happy to underline that the ratio of women to men in the ISU Master of Space Studies program is constantly rising towards an equal balance. Actually, in the Masterclass 2020, we have actually more female than male participants. This is a level of engagement that we need to see throughout the space sector. Before I hand the floor over to our distinguished panelists, I wish to leave you with this message. Give women equal rights and opportunities in the science fields. We can achieve so much more together in a balanced and inclusive society. I now wish you a vibrant panel discussion, and I hope that I can count on you to be a champion of gender equality in space. Thank you very much.